always miss your smile. Everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered. I guess we'll never know. But now you belong to
thank you for the price.
Thank you for the price.
take it all, Lord. Hallelujah. we shout in the house of the Lord today, worthy is the Lamb. Hallelujah,
you
spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother, Anthony Tony Barrow, for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Please silence the cell phones. Or go outside to answer the call. Thank you. Let me start again. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother, Anthony Tony Barrow, for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed by the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also
O God of grace and glory, remember before you this day our brother Anthony. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course in it, till by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. We die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. He brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. We now have the reading of the eulogy. Pardon? Well, my dear, these are the opening sentences that I could read. So,
okay, no problem.
Right, so I could only do what is written in scripture.
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, good morning, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, I am Tony's eldest sister, Maggie. Tony was born, oh, I don't want to cry. Oh, Lord. Okay. I didn't think I would do this. Tony was born on August 30th, 1954 at San Fernando General Hospital. Oh, God. He lived at 3 Lower Hillside with mom and his adoptive family, the Belgroves. Years after, he also lived in Monrepo with childhood best friends, Peter and Oma, and also in Pleasance Park, Pointe Pierre. He attended Corvey Street School until he migrated to Brooklyn, New York. In 1969, in Brooklyn, he attended Wingate High School, where he met his posse, Peter, Richard, and Skillo, to name a few. They all loved partying and being the ladies' man. They even had a special lingo only they could comprehend and took pleasure in it. Tony also loved mining pigeons with Ian, another posse partner. After he accomplished graduating from high school in April 1972, he joined the U.S. Army, and in September he became a father to his one and only child, a son also named Anthony, his pride and joy. In 1975, Tony was honorably discharged from the Army and earned the National Defense Service Medal. Once he was discharged and before his return to Trini in the early 80s, it was very mentally challenging for my brother. Even though he was getting help, Mom was faced to make the hard decision to bring him back to Trinidad after his safety was in jeopardy when someone broke his jaw. Since his return and up to his passing, as the saying goes, there's no place like home. From our family to all of you who treated and took care of him without looking for any monetary compensation, and you took care of him as if he were your flesh and blood and not we cannot thank you enough, but we thank you from the bottom of our heart and know that you will be highly favored and blessed in tenfold. I would say thank you at this time, but that's from me. Now I'm going to read from our younger sister, Maureen. She said, she's in New York. Good morning and hello to everyone. I am both sad and delighted to see all here today, paying final respect to my big brother, Anthony Barrow. Totally devastated, I cannot be there today. However, my sister Maggie is doing the honor of reading something that I have written about Tony and would like to share it with you today. a short version of my brother's life. She said short, but it's about 4 pages. When we were younger, Tony and I were closest as siblings. Tony had a good childhood in Trinidad. I remember us always playing and getting into some type of trouble. One specific memory that registered with me was a mango tree in Granny's backyard. When a strong breeze blew, we'd all run outside to see who could get the most mangoes. I, of course, being the youngest, was usually unlucky in retrieving any. However, ladies and gents, my brother made sure his baby sister had her share. That's how Tony was, a caring and loving brother to me. And even though I followed him around like a tail on his rear end, you know, not once did he tell me to scram, beat it, or get lost. Then mommy brought him to America, and for a while he was out of my life until I joined him here in America. At first, he was in the service, but upon returning home, he was the finest man I ever saw. I recall just how handsome he was in uniform and wearing a long mink coat. I was flabbergasted because previous to that, the last time I saw him, he was a boy, and a few years later, there he stood, a fine young man. I recall both of us grinning from ear to ear. He picked me up, twirled me in the air. I was just elated. My brother was back. Shortly thereafter, Tony became a father, made me an aunt, and mommy a grandmother. His son was named after him and looked like him too. Then came the woman, OMG. Young women threw themselves at him. I became his guard literally. I ushered women out one door while another woman entered the other. I swear it was like revolving doors. We had to be smart so mom wouldn't find out, otherwise we'd both be in a lot of trouble. LOL, it was fun, I might add, and by the way, he paid me for my services. LMAO. Who don't know LMAO? I'm not gonna say what it is. One day something changed him. Abruptly, just like that, like a snap of your fingers, my handsome brother started talking to himself. It went from talking to laughing, then talking and laughing. It was unreal, unpredictable. Needless to say, mommy was frantic. We all were. Couldn't understand what happened. After seeking help from the VA hospital, Kings County Hospital, etc., things were getting back to normal with medication as long as he took it. Tony was now able to get his own apartment. Shortly thereafter, he got a roommate. This person was atrocious, a dangerous person, but we know he didn't know. One night, this roommate and others robbed and beat my brother so bad, they broke his jaw and fractured his ribs. I recalled his mouth wired up and bandaged, wrapped around his ribs to recover from the damage inflicted upon him. That was the last straw for mom, too much. She could have lost her son. Thereafter, when he was healed, she decided to send him back to Trini, where she thought he'd be safe. That was also the last time I saw my brother. I can attest to Tony's life here, as I never had the opportunity to see my brother again. I do know, however, his life was not idealistic. Not for lack of trying, he didn't have the mental capabilities. I believe he didn't have the support system he needed. I'm guessing, but I also think alcohol took away the loneliness and love of family he longed for. I truly believe he was tormented by that. I used to send him things, but what are materialistic things when you have no one and are battling demons? I guess he turned to the bottle to ease his pain and to cope with the loneliness. Mommy tried so hard with him. She did everything humanly possible that we thought was right to help and assist him, yet he gave up. Needless to say, all she wanted was to one day see her firstborn, her only son, thrive, to prosper and grow into a productive member in society. But that, however, was not Tony's fate. Yet he remained respectful and kind to others. My brother, I believe, still had character. I think we can all attest to that. For all who looked after my brother, specifically the Belgroves, who tried endlessly with him, giving him a job, food, sometimes shelter with love, care, and understanding, I humbly thank you very, very much. Sylvia, another angel in Tony's life, thanks from the bottom of my heart for feeding him when he was hungry and seeked you out. You never turned Tony away. You even ensured he maintained proper hygiene at times. Thank you. You all were the family Tony came to love and trust. For all others who cared to seek him out and bless him with a few bucks for food and kind words, thank you. I assure you, it meant the world to him. I ascertain the peace he didn't have in this life, he will have in the next. Let's take this as a lesson to be learned. I took it for granted that I would see my brother again, but I never thought I wouldn't get that chance. Please, everyone, call your loved ones, hold them close, tell them you love them for tomorrow. It may never come, and it would be too late. Thank you all for coming. Thank you.
Next on the program, we have tributes, but a word to the wise. We already had the eulogy, so a tribute is not a eulogy. Please be short and sweet. Thank you. So the
good morning, everyone. I am Leslie Phillip. I live on Lower Hillside Street, two houses away from Tony. I have known Tony and his family since I was in school, a long time ago, over 50 years. In school days, we lived in Pleasance Park, and anything around the house, any trees to cut, to climb, Dad would call Tony, bring him up from Lower Hillside. Then when I got married, about 38 years ago, Tony also became our handyman. My new bride was very scared of him. Our children were also very scared of him, until they all understood and accepted him. Tony would come to wash our cars. In the middle of washing the car, he would stop looking in the car windows, take out his Afro comb, and start to comb his hair. And his hair was his main thing. He did cause quite a stir at our daughter's 16th birthday party. Mr. Tony walked straight through the garage into the birthday party and told my daughter he wanted a booze. Of course, then he had all the convent girls screaming because they had no idea who was this man that just walked in. So my daughter said, that's all right, that's our neighbor Tony, he just wants some booze. In our community, lots of people looked out for Tony, and Tony looked out for a lot of people. Tony literally drank water and mind his business. Or I should say, really that should be, Tony drank liquor and mind his business. Tony, at the corner, he had lots of friends. Janice, Anim, Alette, Django, Ming, Baggy, Nutsman, and his son, Vicky, Chunky, Jerry Bandan, Timmy, Ronald, Desperate, Christine looked after him. She was the one to clean out, go clean the house, and Roderick would wash all his clothes. He ran a lot of errands for the neighbors. Run errands for Django, Mr. Hoyt, Miss Singh Tia, involve many people. From paying bills, going to the post office, bringing papers, playing playway. They all spoke about Tony's honesty, his ability to make message and bring the correct change, always very pleasant, always very well-mannered. I recall we would normally give Tony breakfast, and one morning when we were retired, Tony came down the hill and passed in the house street. So I said, "Tony, want to have no breakfast today?" He said, "Yeah, I see husband and wife having breakfast there, so I didn't want to disturb." His head was always in the right place, even though many people didn't think so. I remember he asked to use my address as his mailing address. Tony came, got the documents for me to fill out, asked for my ID card, asked for a copy of the light bill. I gave it to him because I trusted him, and Tony brought it back. Then one day he said he had a check. It was a cross check, but it needed to be open for him to get it. And the authorities told him he had to take it to Port of Spain to get it open. So he asked if I will take him. I said, "Sure, I'll take you. Shower, and I'll take you to Port of Spain." I took him, we got it done. To my great surprise, when we came back, Tony said to me, "Well, you know the car didn't go up on water. The car used gas." He said, "Hold that for gas, and hold that, buy lunch for you and the wife." That was Tony. I also got a learning experience, because when my wife make breakfast for him, she would go that extra mile and put everything in the sandwich, while I will just put the basic. She will have to, she's doing a ham and sandwich for him, she will put the lettuce, the chow chow, everything. And then I got buff, because she will tell me that Tony is an ordinary person, he's a child of God. So you can't be doing it halfway, it's either you're doing it full or not. So then she will also put the sandwiches in a sandwich bag, and then a next bag, and all these fancy things. So I said, "Well, you know, Tony's just going to litter the road, he don't need all these things." But that was just the relationship we had. And we just wanted to thank the staff also. I got to know Melissa and Brent and Mrs. Figaro about 1 year ago when Dawn had to leave. She told me she will put me onto these people. And Melissa and they really came forward and treated Tony like family. So we then became extended family also, with Melissa and I taking the reins with Tony, taking him, having him to go to the doctor and all that. His health really started to deteriorate in 2021. He went to the hospital, he ran away in April 2022, and in August 2019, he was hospitalized again, he ran away. And this last time in September, he just couldn't make it again. He was just too weak. He couldn't run away. He was there from about mid-September, and then he passed on the 5th. So we just wanted to say, rest in peace, my neighbor. Rest in peace, my brother. Thank you.
Good morning to all.
Good morning.
I wouldn't be as long as the previous speaker. All I have to say is that Tony and I grew up together, and Janice also. And you know, I had a friend in Tony. I never missed an opportunity to speak to Tony, because we grew up together. And you know what was enlightening about Tony? Tony was a trustworthy person. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Terry. I'll be okay.
You want me to leave you?
I'm good, thanks, appreciate it.
Okay.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Terry. I'm one of Tony's many cousins. The Barrows do get it wrong. But anyway, I want to take this moment to give my condolences to my Aunt Jo.
You didn't say it to me, Mike. Oh, Terry, you'll be all right.
And to his sisters, Maggie, Warren, Media.
You want me to read it for you?
No. Oh. And all the nephews, nieces, friends, family. I also wanted to welcome everyone else who I don't remember, don't know, I was too little. I would like to take an opportunity just to give you a brief remembrance of how I remember. Tony was he was considerate, he was caring. I remember him as being very protective of me when I was a little boy. Other kids would try to get me in trouble. When they found out Tony was my cousin, they would leave me alone. So you can see, I looked up to Tony. But as much as I knew him when I was little, he was going to New York at the time. And when I finally saw him, I clearly remember this. I landed in New York City. It was cold, wintry, and I decided to walk out the door, see what it's like. Well, foolish me. The cold temperatures seemed like it just waited on me. I knew I was a fast runner, but I probably broke Usain Bolt's record running back. But like at night, Tony showed up and he brought a big fur coat. You have to have high emotional intelligence and empathy for other people. I mean, that was Tony. I only remember good things about it. In the latter days, whenever I saw him, he would just say family. Because that's all he could say. He didn't say much. But he always had a smile on his face. It was heartbreaking when I found the news out. I didn't know I had to be here. On a reflective note, this, what I got from Tony was, and the significance of what he taught me, is that life is short. That we should not let much time go by not keeping in touch with each other. We should care about each other. We know life is busy, but at least you can pick the phone up or you can visit someone. You know, Dale Carnegie once wrote that, and I'm paraphrasing, is that you shouldn't complain about other people. You shouldn't criticize. What you should do is compliment them, support them, uplift them. Let's take this moment to celebrate Tony, because that's what I remember him. A caring, compassionate man. And I miss Tony. Thank you.
in the midst of life we are in debt. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by our sins are justly angered. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secret of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our prayers, but spare us, O Lord. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. We now sing the hymn on the program, Amazing Grace. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Anthony. We pray that having opened to him the gates of larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, he may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We now have the first reading of Scripture. Someone be nice to come and do that portion of Scripture, Revelation 21, 2 to 7. Anyone? Thank you.
Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from a spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be God. I will be their God, and they will be my children. But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the populated, the polluted, I think that's it, the murderers, the fornicators, the sorcerers, their place will be in the lake that burns with fire and sulfur, which is a second death."
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The 23rd Psalm will now be sung to the version of Crimmon. Comes from Mark chapter 10, verses 13 to 16. People were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them. And his disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them. For it is to such as those that these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will not enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. The word of the Lord. Before the message this morning, we sing the hymn on the program, "Just a Closer Walk with God." Sorry, with D. My reflection this morning are taken from the words that Paul wrote in the Epistle to the Romans, the 8th chapter, the 38th to the 39th verses. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Friends gathered, I speak in the name of God, the Father, Jesus, the risen Son, and the guiding Holy Spirit. Amen. First, let me, on behalf of the parish where I serve as priest, the Anglican parish of St. Augustine Liberi, express deepest condolences to the relatives, friends, loved ones, and all concerned of our deceased brother, Anthony Tony Barrow, whom God called out of this world on the 5th day of October, 2022. My name is Father Harold Dickerson, priest in the Church of God. Friends gathered, whenever we hear these three words at the beginning of the text, I am sure we are reminding ourselves that some form of discussion is taking place between two persons at least. And the people speaking to each other is saying in no uncertain terms, with conviction, certainty, and assurance, that something is happening at the moment, is about to happen, or will take place in the not too distant future. And Paul set it out very nicely in the book of Romans to the people in Rome. He said that he's sure that neither death nor life, angels, principalities, powers, things present, things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will ever be able to separate us, and I change it a moment, will ever be able to separate Anthony Barrow from the love of God in Christ Jesus, his Lord. We are gathered on this Wednesday morning, which is the 12th day of October 2022 in Belgrove's prayer room in San Fernando, saying farewell to a tremendous servant of God who served and lived for 68 years of life on this earth. And as I continue in reflection, we heard many things in the eulogy and tributes. And one thing I picked up is that Anthony knew how to live in the community, amongst friends, loved ones, and all concerned. And for that, Anthony was able to touch lives, which is important as we all continue our journey, course, and life on earth. We must also remember, in no uncertain terms, that God gives life and takes it in his time, not in our time. He gave Anthony that first breath of life at birth on the 30th day of August, 1954, and he took it away from him 5th October, 2022. And I want to also say that death is something that will not tell us when it is coming. However, friends gathered, debt will come to every one of us. Only who was not born will not die. Nice small thing. Nice part I agree with him. Nice small thing. I got an answer. I understand. Small thing. Nice small thing. No. Nice small thing. I understand. You know, take it easy. Anyhow. As I was saying, and will continue to say, death will come to everyone except who wasn't born. And that's a known fact. If you wasn't born, you wouldn't die because you wasn't here. Is that small, as the young people say, that's a small thing. We understand that. But you know what I want to say too? This priest will die too, you know. I know it's strange about it. When I die, I will know one thing what the people say. Because I'll be lying in a box, like Anthony. But as I continue reflection, what I want to say to everyone this morning, gathered. And do not ever forget this as you continue your journey and course on it. Every morning your eyes are open, thank God. Anthony could do such until the 5th of October when he left. Because when your eyes are open daily, my people, that is the greatest blessing God bestows upon every human being. Everything else that comes after that breath of life bestowed upon human beings who live life daily in God's time and place is just added blessing. The breakfast, lunch, dinner, or supper. Children could go to school today. Yes, school is in operation. Teachers could go and all of that. People could go to different places of work. That's just added blessings. And God decided in his loving mercy, wisdom, and knowledge to bless, as we heard in the gospel. He blessed all the children. Let all the children come to me, he said in the gospel, or as we would hear from time to time, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Anthony received such, and all of us continue to receive daily blessings from God. We have to also remember, friends, gathered, as we snap a finger, which is a second, that is like that. As I said, it will not tell us when it's coming, but the important thing for us to do daily as believers is to have a spiritual connection with Christ. Know your Christ. Do not only know your Christ when you were ill, and you got better, and as some Trinidadians do, and I say this all here, through a big fit. They say thanks to God yet for healing them, you know. But you know Trinidadians like to party. Nice small thing, eh? But I want to say this as well. God sees and knows everything that we think, say, and do. Which reminds us that because human beings, to which we are all considered as, have not been born and created perfect in God's image and likeness. We make mistakes, and we need to say to God, we are sorry. Father Dickerson makes mistakes. He says to God, he's sorry. Nobody is perfect, because if people were born perfect, you wouldn't have no need for me today to come and say and do this service for Anthony, because everybody will know everything. And that is how life is. But the God that you serve, I serve, and Anthony serve, gives us chances when we fall short of the glory to pick up our pieces, ask for our shortcomings to be forgiven, and move on in our daily lives. We have to also understand that the lifespan of a man, woman is, anybody knows? Yes, 70 years. 70. Anthony missed it by 2 years. But he was almost the reach there. But God gives life, as I said, and he takes it in his time, and we don't ever question his judgment. It goes on to say, lifespan of man, woman is 70, in good health, 80, and anything after 80 is in God's time. So we understand. And I see my good friend here, George, is laughing because he knows he's living in God's time now. And I say no more, because he didn't know I was listening to what he was telling this guy here. He's 88. I must be too fast, but you know, that is part of the thing. But we thank God for the life, the witness, and the time that he allowed Anthony to live with us. He, as I said at the beginning, as a true servant of God, to serve in the army not easy. And I guess he served with distinction, and then he went through, as Maggie said, a little challenging time when he got somebody beat him up, and they had to put things to fix his mouth. But he didn't give up. He came back to Trinidad, and things continued to go as God wanted it to do and be how it was. But I want us to always remember, my friends, and let us not forget this factor as well. We have gone through a challenging time, and still is, although the country has opened back up. You know what I'm talking about, the pandemic, coronavirus, COVID-19 thing, and all kind of vaccine people take. The vaccine of the place. Well, I preach every Italy take vaccine too, eh? A nice small thing. You know, everybody, you know, vaccine thing. But as I say that, let us not forget that COVID-19 continues to cause trouble in families' lives. You know why is that? In 1 week, in some instances, 2 family members gone one time. Thank God that Anthony did not pass on with COVID. You know why? Let me tell you why. Because all also the service done. It's a quick service. And not only that, it seems like how the casket sealed. That is how it would have been. And you're seeing some kind of picture of the person where people, you notice you came in and you could have looked at his face. Right. So we thank God that that didn't happen. But as I continue, I want us to take the next thought with us for the rest of our lives. I want us to live with love. Love of Christ. Love of God. Love of self. Love of neighbor. Daily. Always. In our hearts. Let me explain. When the disciples asked Jesus, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment?" He said, "The first is as great as the second. The first is love God with your whole heart, mind, soul, and strength. And the second one that has given people real trouble is what? Love your neighbor as yourself." Oh, God, boy, no, good boy, he's real good students, boy. But let's look at, loving your neighbor as yourself. In a way, when you look at it and you spin it a little bit, you have to love yourself first, eh? Because you can't say you're loving your neighbor and hate yourself. So let me quickly show you how to love yourself. Everybody here sitting, listening to this priest with a big head, knows that before they came here this morning and they prepared themselves, they looked in the mirror. Didn't you look in a mirror? Yeah. Everybody house have a mirror, right? Yeah. Who do you see when they look in the mirror? Yourself. Right. Now, listen carefully to this one. When last did you look in the mirror and say to God, "You are happy with how you are looking"? Don't try to say. Don't, hey, watch, don't, careful. Right. Or I could give you another twist of it a bit. Or you said to God, "I am happy how I was born and how I've grown up." I love myself because you're talking to yourself and you're seeing yourself in the mirror. And then and only then you could love your neighbor as yourself. But you know, as we continue life, we understand at times that some Trinidadians, not all you, not these lovely people watching here in this program, what they call here, this kind of funeral place thing, what they call it here, not all you. Some people does only love people 2 days in the year. Ah, boy, these people, all a real bright boy, I had to teach all anything again. Christmas and Valentine's or Valentine Day as the children see. Watch it, eh? All through the year. Let's deal with Valentine's Day, because I didn't want early in the year. All up till the 13th of February, hatred, quarreling. But it's so deceitful and hypocritical that on the 14th, they go and buy all kind of love. Yeah, well, you know, we have, and I'm bashing all the men, eh? You remember I say no, all you. But anyhow, they buy all kind of lovely teddy bear, roses, and gooses, and whatever they call them. And big, full up the tank, as the gentleman said, he got gas free, right? They go in and take the love, well, the one that they say they love, to the Hyatt and Hilton. Right? Listen to that. Like the 14th. And the 15th. Quarrel again. Bow slap. People, you cannot love somebody 24 hours before and hate them 24 hours after. That hypocrisy. That deceitfulness. That everything all you know are talking about. And it's the same thing for Christmas Day. You're talking to your neighbor. But you know you're smelling the ham and thing cooking Christmas Eve. And Christmas Day, you're gone in the people house and you're so greedy. You know, eat more than the people who cook the thing. And you drink more than them who, you know? And boxing morning, you can't tell the people good morning. People, I want to tell you this as well. We have to live with this psalm and verse. This verse, I should say, this verse of this psalm in our lives. Psalm 51:11. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Anthony had a clean heart, and God renewed a right spirit in him throughout the rest of his life until he passed on. That inject love. Because people have to understand, you're not sure that you'll be here tomorrow. Because, as the saying goes, never leave what you can do today, because tomorrow may never come. People live it. Don't talk it, live it. And you know, sometimes when I do funeral services, well, not this one, people that say, priest, you always say there's sin. I say, yes, you there's sin too. Don't try to judge me. Let Jesus judge me. I'm not judging you. I'm not judging Anthony. I never say this. No, I never come here this morning and say I'm judging Anthony. Judgment Day will come and Jesus will deal with that. And he will give an account of the 68 years he spent on this earth. And I wonder, where Maggie? She gone so? Anyhow, she here in Judy though. Family members of Anthony Barrow, it has some people. When they do hear in time that somebody pass on, they feel there is the best bush pathologist. What do I mean by that? They want to find out where the person died from. Them is not God. Them is not the doctor. People had to learn when loved ones lost a family member. They need words of comfort, not words of commerce. Family, and this lady, you look family-ish. Because I see your command here was holding. I know your name, I want to know. But I will figure it out eventually, because I'll go by the, I'm not frightened, I'm going to buy the place where they go and do the burial to that small thing. Hear this. Family members, when you hear them kind of people call all you, and all you, and all you crying and still grieving, and they start to talk foolishness, tell them this. Michelle, you sing it, you know. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green paths. And you're so quick, they will stop talking to you. People don't know the place. Leave, I want to say it like this. Leave commerce for 10 generations to come when we're not here. Not in this generation. People don't know the place. And they just call it, they like to call, you know, they just like to call priests. I say, I don't want to hear it. All right. You're saying this, that, and the other body person. Like three things you tell me, bad body person. Tell me three good things about them. They don't stop talking to me. Gotta stop that. Life too short. As they always say, I want to say this as well. Live good in your neighborhood. Why? Because when you're living good in your neighborhood, most of the time the family members are a little far off. And when you live good in your neighborhood, something happened to you. Some illness, they will seek your assistance and then they will pick up the phone and call your family. But if you're not living good, you'll stay there and then. Right, Maggie, I'm calling him. I know you had to come back, but I want to call him again. Maggie got emotional and we want to know all your name, but small thing. Right. Tears began to flow. You know why? Because Jesus himself, in the Gospel of John 11 chapter, the 21st to the 27th verse, when he was having a discussion with the sisters of the brother who had died called Lazarus, he said, hey, Martha said, hey, Jesus, if you were present, our brother would not have died. She showed trust, faith, and belief in him. And what happened? He said, all right, your brother will rise to life again in the resurrection on the last day. He said, take me to the place called the tomb where you buried him. And you know what he did? Jesus started to cry. First thing he do, you know. Yes, somebody knew the scripture. Good boy, you wept. You don't go to plenty church, you know that. You don't go to plenty church and think. Right. Jesus wept, showing that he's always in human form. He never felt he bigger than nobody, so he crying for a good friend, and it's happening here this morning as well, because they have family and have friends here, and you know, you know how it is, crying for the loved one. And then he said, okay, now I'm going and enact the next thing. I'm going and perform the miracle of the resurrection. Lazarus, arise, come out of the grave. And what was he doing there? Removing the tears from Martha and Mary's eyes. And this is what we are praying for, to Jesus, to remove the tears from our eyes on the resurrection day, when Anthony will rise back to life and go before Christ to give an account of the 68 years he spent on this earth. So family members, when all you feel to cry, cry. Anthony understands. God understands. Jesus understands. And you will understand, because Anthony played a part in your life. He would have made some form of difference or little impact or what have you. But you could, we could all safely say he would have left a legacy that somebody could remember him for whatever, and take some little part of his life and use it to move on with their own life. I'm nearly done, eh? Don't worry. But I want to say this as well. God is good. And his mercy will and shall endure forever and ever. Barrow family, Father Dickerson will keep you in his presence. And no Friday, you know how to communicate with people, eh? Because that is important. Go down in the valley and talk to Jesus, because Jesus always answers prayer. Anthony, my brother, farewell. You have run the race. You have finished the course. Rest in peace. Rise in glory. Go before Christ to give an account of the 68 years you spent on this earth on the resurrection day, where you will be told by Jesus on that day, go into the place called heaven to be with God, Jesus, the angels, and all who enter there. Rest eternal grant unto our brother Anthony Barrow, Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May his soul and all the faithful depart through the mercy of Almighty God. Rest in peace and rise in glory. And the people of God all say, amen.
Amen.
Before we have the next hymn, I'll just do the Apostles' Creed and an intercession, and then we'll have the hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Your response to the intercession this morning, when I say, Lord, graciously hear us, you will respond, hear us, Lord. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ. Our Lord, give to your whole church in heaven and earth your light and your peace. Lord, graciously hear us. May all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection die to sin and rise to newness of life. May we, with him, pass through the grave and the gate of death to our joyful resurrection. Lord, graciously hear us. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, graciously hear us. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Lord, graciously hear us. Grant to us who mourn for Antony, assure assurance in your loving care, that casting all their sorrows on you, Jesus, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, graciously hear us. Give courage and faith to the Barrow family, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and certain hope and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. Lord, graciously hear us. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Antony, who was born by water and spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us your victory over death. Be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. We now sing the hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, after which the commendation of the body will take place here, and the committal will be done at the in Tacarigua. Is Tacarigua called here, Tunapuna? Well, Trincity, where all you know are talking about.
When sorrow and pain are no more, I decide of life everlasting. You are only a immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, the immortal form of the earth, and earth shall be returned. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust. The demon of the grave, we make our song. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, and to meet your saints. When sorrow and pain are no more, neither sign of life everlasting. Let us commend our brother Anthony to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Anthony, O suffering Lord Christ, from all evil. Set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in eternal habitation, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Anthony. Now let we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, lamb of your own flock, sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy in the blessed rest of everlasting peace and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. We'll have the recessional hymn and the viewing of the body before we proceed to Trincity. Thank you.
I sail into all gray.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Our condolences to the Barrow family. My name is Kimmy. We live down the street neighborhood. I just have two things to say. I want to say all this here. All of us live down there, street in St. Martin Street, you know. I just wanted to mention two things. I never knew that Tony was so handsome. I look, you know, honestly, I look at Tony in the slideshow and this thing. I never knew he was so handsome. He was a real debonair looking guy. Anyway, I want to give a quick joke. Now, to know Tony, you had to really understand Tony, because not every time he would talk. Alicia's husband, who is now deceased, David Graham, we all made a we were sitting down one day. We had some little lime there home. And David made this joke. He said, one day, somebody asked Tony for help. They was carrying something heavy. It was like a box with something. It was heavy, though. Equipment or something. And Tony held on to one thing, and the other two guys held on to the other parts of the box, and they were carrying this thing with the equipment. And so David made this joke, and he said, you know, Tony walked with his friend and them. I didn't really understand what he meant, because Tony talks to himself, like most of us know. Most of us talk to ourselves. And Tony was holding the box, and he said, like, all right, okay, I'll come in here. Yeah, but I tell you, don't you know, and he dropped the box, and it damaged all the thing, and we all had a laugh about that, because Tony had this way about him. And you know, when you're talking to Tony, sometimes he would be mum, or he would just hum, you know? And Tony was such a gentle soul, but you had to understand him to relate to him. You know, sometimes in the early first thing in the morning, 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning, he'd want a cigarette, and he wouldn't know how to ask, just a viral cigarette. He'd be coming, and he'd make these signals, but you had to know him. So my thing is that we will miss Tony. He was a part of our neighborhood. He was part of our family. He was part of everything with us. And he would be dearly missed, you know? So that's all I want to say. Our condolences to the family. Stay strong and stay strong in the Lord. You know? And that's the only hope that we have. So God bless you all. Take care. Take care. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never.
trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great is our God! And all will see how great, how great. Thank you.
different when I want. I look different when I take off the white. Yes.
Here.
Remember your message.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are about to begin.
Can I ask you something?
Good afternoon, everyone. You can be seated. Welcome to Orange Grove Memorial Gardens. Before we start today, I would just like to give the safety announcements. Now, if anyone needs to use the bathroom, it's in the main building to your left. When we are ready to put the casket in, please, everyone, stay behind the green ribbons unless directed that you can go behind. Okay? That's it. I'll hand over now to Pastor Dickerson.
Thank you. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I am about to do the committal of the body before it goes into the crypt. I call it crypt. Well, same thing. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to immortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad. My spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Jesus. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in debt. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secret of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure uncertain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Anthony Barrow, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. When our well-beloved son Jesus comes again in judgment, both this our brother Anthony, we ourselves be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer for the Barrow family. Grant, O Lord, the Barrow family now in bereavement, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come, with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal, grant unto our brother Anthony, O Lord. Let light perpetual shine upon him. May his soul and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. The Lord bless him. The Lord keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him. The Lord be gracious to him and give him peace. His countenance be upon him always. Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of Almighty God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and remain with our brother Anthony this afternoon, tomorrow, and forevermore. Amen. Brother Anthony, rest in peace and rise in glory on the resurrection day. Amen. Abounds in deepest waters.
Thank you. raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me
Upon the waters, the great unknown. find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. Thank you.
Ooh.